guys. Welcome back to NASCAR Fantasy Fastlane. I'm Jessica Ruffin here with NBC Sports' Steve Letarte. Steve, we're heading to Darlington Raceway this weekend. Throwback weekend for NASCAR. It's always a fun weekend. When you look at your starting lineup, when you look at Martin Truex Jr., Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick, we talk about it every week. If you have any usages left, what are you looking at for this weekend?
Well, you need to play them. All three are Southern 500 winners. They know how to win at the track, too tough to tame. So the real question is usages. If you only have one left, maybe someone like Kyle Busch, I would say, for the Brickyard. But me, I'm out of Kevin Harvick usages. That stings a little bit. But Truex will be in my lineup, and Kyle Busch will also be in my lineup.
Well, let's talk about some of the guys we don't normally talk about. Some of the guys that have had really strong performances lately. Some of the guys like Ryan Blaney, Chase Elliott, Kurt Busch. Do you think any of those guys will fare well this weekend at Darlington?
Well, you mentioned their recent success. We talk a lot about the big three, but I think these guys have turned into the big four of fantasy in recent weeks. When you look at their numbers over the last 6 weeks, they're outstanding. Kurt Busch, okay, I'm going to admit it. My big miss of the year has been Kurt Busch at Bristol. I had him not even in my lineup. He went out. He won the race. And look at the average points, over 38 over the last six races. Ryan Blaney as well, super consistent, over 39 points. Those are great numbers when you look at fantasy. Chase Elliott, he's outstanding at over 45. But surprisingly, of these four, Erik Jones, even though perhaps 32 points an average over the last nine races, he's the one I'm going to start out of these four when it comes to Darlington. His numbers there are very, very good. Even though he only has one Cup start, every time he gets in a car there, Xfinity or Cup, he runs well.
Let's get a few more of your picks in for Darlington, and we will start with somebody who knows Darlington very well, Denny Hamlin.
Denny Hamlin is a must-start this weekend. The two-time Southern 500 winner won this race a year ago. Although the car was found to have a little issue in post-race inspection, that doesn't bother me at all. I expect him to run well again this weekend at a very difficult racetrack.
Ryan Newman.
Well, surprisingly, Ryan Newman is going to be a start again. I haven't said that much this year, but Darlington is his best track by average finish. He has top 10 in four of the last five Darlington starts. His consistency really shows up at that tough racetrack.
Kyle Larson.
Kyle Larson, also a start. When is he going to break through? It's going to have to be coming. He has top 10 in three of four Darlington races. We talk about a guy that loves running the top. Well, at Darlington, there's only a top groove. That really suits Kyle Larson.
Let's talk strategy a little bit at Darlington because it's definitely one of the toughest racetracks on the circuit. You know, you've got that rough surface. The tire wear is a big factor there. What kind of strategy plays do you envision for this weekend?
Well, Jessica, the teams are going to have 13 sets of tires. They're going to need every one of them because 500 miles at Darlington is the longest race of the year. I know it's 100 miles short than the 600-mile race at Charlotte. But the Southern 500, statistically, over 4 hours at a track that is very difficult to race on, patience. You're going to have a tremendous amount of patience to manage the racetrack, manage your equipment.
When you look at our leaderboard right now in our league, two races left to go, and Chris leading our league right now, and I'm a little jealous of his spot, I'm not going to lie.
Well, you're not doing bad. You're inside the top 100. I feel pretty good at myself inside the top 75. But really what surprises me is when you look at their numbers. I mean, these guys are stacked together really within 100 points inside the top four. That could be a good or a bad week on the bonus picks. That could jumble up the whole leaderboard.
Well, you know bonus picks are always key every single week. So what's your winner pick for this weekend?
All right, a little surprise for everybody. Denny Hamlin, the 11 of the FedEx Toyota. That is who I think is going to go to victory lane. He knows how to win at Darlington. He won there last year, winless in 2018. This is a guy that has Hall of Fame numbers. I think he's going to win the race, carry the momentum all the way through the playoffs.
Let's see if Denny Hamlin can get it done this weekend. Be sure you guys set your lineups in. Get your throwback gear. It's throwback weekend. Steve and I are rocking some vintage-inspired NASCAR shirts. And you guys can get your own.
And if you want to tune in, it's Sunday, 6 p.m. NBCSN. It's Driver's Booth Weekend. Myself, Jeff Burton, Dale Jr. will come cover the Southern 500 this weekend.